Thank you, Wan. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think with 10 minutes I can transform all of you to love palm oil. But India being number one consumer as far as Malaysian sustainable palm oil is concerned, I don't think if it is unsustainable we are here in this lovely room. With the motivating speech by the Honorable Minister, can someone? Yes, that's it. Okay, anyway, I am trained by, never mind, they are still doing it, but I can speak, I don't want to waste time, like you Honorable Minister. Without India, without China, without Europe, I don't think we are here today. And I'm so glad the custodian and the man in charge of the dedicated legislation called Malaysian Palm Oil Board Act 1998 is none other than Dr. Parvez. He is not only the regulator, he is the collector of taxes, cess, etc., etc., etc. Do you think he is my enemy? Wan Aisyah, she claims she is the new lady in the block. No, she is the marketing person. But she doesn't have the advantage of height. And I can tell you, size matters. Dr. Majid, trained by CDC, Commonwealth Development Corporation, 48 years ago. But without science, without evidence, Desmodium oviliferum is a leguminous cover crop. And my goodness, Mukuna Bhaktijata originated from this humble place called India. My God, if this place is not fertile, do you think your politician and your technocrat, private sector, small players, the farmers, are willing to fulfill what the state government is desiring? My slide is very simple. The three of us are government servants, and we sacrifice 4 votes, I think. And can you imagine, I'm so angry, the three of them can cast their vote early in the morning because we are taking the flight midnight. I can't catch the flight to my humble village in Sabah. So as human, I can be very angry, but I can be very, very friendly. Therefore, India, by virtue of an invitation by IVPA and signing the document, this is the beginning of another journey of not only fellowship, friendship, but I think it's win-win, isn't it, Tuan? I think a big hand to him, because this is his kampung. How important when you consume what we produce and doesn't talk bad about us or being silly by boycotting us. I don't think robot do that. But human being, like the 251 of us here, have emotion. And if I can entice you all, yes, as I said, there are only about 7 slides. Next, please. Thank you. The timeline, the same word. My good lady here, she took that from the history book of Malaysian palm oil, 103 years to be exact. Without science, without evidence base, do you think we can travel this? But to convince human beings, including me, when Malaysian sustainable palm oil was introduced 7 years ago, my God, it took us about 2-3 years to convince the entire stakeholder in Malaysia. Small men, small women, big estate, medium-sized estates. How did we do it? Very simple. Parvez can be very nasty. He's a scientist. He tried to be a lawyer like me. And I said, Parvez, let me strangle you first. Then Parvez said, Daud, I'll strangle you. I think that is what relationship is about. We embrace each other, not by fighting, but by embracing each other. And I think the future of palm oil is also the same thing. My brother, Indian, because Malaysia is ready to help you. The planting material is not cheap. And you have mentioned it this morning. When the demand is there, I am sure my fellow businessman is going to up the price. And it is duty bound for me, Aisha, Parvez, to convince our business people, don't do that. That is unfriendly. And in the same thing, when the European said doubt, what is wrong with you guys? Are we expanding? Reforestation, orangutan and all that. I am one of the orangutan because orangutan is only native in Borneo. They are my cousin. And I can tell you there is no orangutan in Peninsula Malaysia. Malaysia did not develop planting new. No, we transplant or we change from rubber to palm oil. We change cocoa to palm oil. Our nation is very serious, brother. They kept it using the force of law to only plant oil palm 6 million hectare. And ask Parvez, it has been stagnant, 5.7, 5.8, because he's the custodian to the law. But using law alone will not convince you to protect the environment. Environment doesn't speak, but when it floods, strong winds kills. So therefore, ladies and gentlemen, we must stop being silly. Let's fall in love with each other, if possible. It's a production of Malaysian Indian. And I am sure I was told, your husband in Canada, your children in Canada, why not India? My teachers are all from University of Kerala, and that is why my biology is strong. My English literature is strong. Why? Because they believe in touching the human, people to people. Mrs. Esau, Mrs. Abraham, Kerala Christian, what's wrong with that? Now, I'm a Muslim. Do you think I'm as holy as Mr. Abraham? As long as we speak the truth, MSPO is a legal mechanism through the Mann Act, MPOB Act. Therefore, you cannot mind. You cannot malas. You don't conform to MSPO, Parvez will not renew MSPO license. Copy that, brother. The small farmer, gratis, help them. The big estate, tax them. And can you imagine, Minister of Finance, very smart. When the price shoot up sky high, they invented one new tax. Prosperity tax. What the hell is that, Parvez? Any company with net profit of 100 million will be imposed certain percentage on what you have profited. Prosperity tax. And can you imagine the biggest devil in Malaysia? Two things only. Windfall profit tax is imposed on me. I am angry with both of them. But to the smallholders, it's not affected. We only tax the super, super big boys. And I can tell you, brother, we have a lot of cooperatives in Malaysia, which basically also conform to SME requirement. Therefore, as long as you conform to the legislation of the sovereign state, don't be angry with the consuming country. We are heading to China next year, Dato', ya? And Dato' Parvez is a very good tax collector. He already demand, oh, squeeze my belt, Dato' Daud, I need you some money to do promotion in China. He is a smart civil servant. And that is why the people-to-people connection is crucial. Embrace each other, and in Malaysia, the success of Malaysian sustainable palm oil is because of the cohesive and the serious commitment from the government, private sector, smallholders, small farmers, and my funding. When I say my funding, Malaysian Palm Oil Certification Council. We are spending time and resources touching the schools. Like as much as my school teacher 48 years ago touched my heart to protect the environment. Never easy. Mr. Abraham got to whip me with the rattan for not forgetting what is productive system. And today I think I'm a viable, productive man because I produce two small kids. At the age of 64, I'm just trying to emphasize the importance of biology, the importance of chemistry, and the importance of physics. Combined it with sensible mind, I think this nation can produce for your own consumption. It is okay to dream, why not? And I tell you just one simple point, which Mr. Abraham taught me, because I read scripture. Ask and thou shalt be given. The first A is attitude. S is skills, it can be acquired easily. K is the knowledge. My goodness, Google SEX, Dato' Parbes, what do you see? Like your minister asked us to Google, Dr. Parbes, where is your machine? He doesn't have a phone. Aisha, and I can tell you I was taught this because serve regulation is important. The E is the experience. India, learn from our experience. Don't repeat our mistakes. So that you can catapult your progress. And D is the discipline. And discipline, in my humble view, is where MSPO is leading the country further. To fulfill the basic needs of food for human, feed for animal and human, and another F is for the energy. With that note, I'm trying to stop. It's 10 minutes. Wabillahi taufiq walidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.
Thank you, Dato' Daud. Wow. Biologically fit.